Rotom has the right idea. This place is, it's got bad written all over it. Let's bring Plague up to the front. And we'll use a healing item on Smidvarg. Super potion, there we go. So yeah, how are you guys coping, viewers? Has the shock been purged out of your systems? Are you getting used to the fact that Aether Foundation isn't quite the nice group of Pokemon conservationists you thought they were? Yeah, it looks like they're doing some pretty interesting stuff down here. But we just gotta see for ourselves what that is. Intruder spotted. We'll protect our secret labs. Okay, three more fights before we can discover what they've been doing down here. Alright, just one Pokemon. Muk. Alright. Let's go for this, Plague. You can do this. Why? Because you're awesome, that's why. Nice try, but I'm a fellow Dark-type. And it doesn't knock off the Z-Crystal, I noticed. Interesting. Okay, there goes your living acid trip. It seems as though I may have lost. Yeah, what gave it away? There are only researchers like us here in the secret labs. Looks like I'm next. I'll show you the power of Aether Paradise. You guys spend all day cooped up in your labs. How powerful of a trainer could you be? Alright, Magneton. Perfect, I've got my fire type. Give it a quick Fire Fang, and all will be good. Oh, Sturdy. Of course, Sturdy. And we'll finish this off with, I don't know, Lick. Which we still have yet to get rid of. Maybe we should replace it with Brick Break, so that we can keep brick-breaking things. I haven't done enough development work on Pokemon battles. As I was saying, you can't be too powerful if you're stuck cooped up in a lab all day. We're currently working on the development of a new Pokeball. It is apparently used to catch Pokemon not found in Alola. How about I guess what you're looking for? Cosmog, right? If you want to know what kinds of experiments we did with it, you'll have to beat me. They're doing experiments on Nebby? How monstrous can you get? That's a rhetorical question, by the way. I know perfectly well how monstrous these people can be. And for those of you who don't know, well, you're in for a surprise. A really nasty surprise. Okay, Porygon 2. What have you got for us? Okay, it traces the Blaze ability. It doesn't have any Fire-type moves, so completely useless. Let's spin to win. And finish with leech life, get a little bit of health back. Remember, Plague is a superhero vampire cat wrestler. He's got a lot on his resume. You really do just win, don't you? Honesty seems like the way to go. All I can tell you is that Cosmog is the key. It's the tool needed to open the Ultra Wormhole. But I'm no good at battling, so I'm out of here. Cosmog is the key to opening the wormhole. That certainly sounds suspicious, does it not? Let's head for Secret Lab B. But, you doing out here, Gladion? It's not here. Don't even think about getting in here. Me and Null, we're more alike than we might look. We're both what we were made to be. I was like an ornament to my mother, wearing whatever she told me to wear. Acting however she wanted me to act. Null was crafted just as carefully. It was made just to battle the beasts. In this room, right here. So, intriguing bit of backstory. Now we know why a Null is not quite like other Pokemon. It was created, which is quite creepy. Oh, but Secret Lab B is already occupied, it seems. How is, like, he's marveling at the technology. This research is our life. I don't care if you're a kid or what. I'll send you flying if you threaten it. Double battle? That's what I'm hoping. How and me, we're the ultimate team. Just try it, guys. I dare you. Machoke and Vanillish. Okay, Plague and Raichu. This is like the perfect counter to Machoke and Vanillish. I'll just use Fire Fang on the Ice Cream Cone. And Raichu will probably use Psychic on Machoke. Boom. Get wrecked. Flamethrower, oh. You know what, why not? We'll just forget this move. We'll forget Lick. Even though Incineroar's special attack is not very impressive, we'll just use a Flamethrower for now anyway. And crunch. I just ate your ice cream. And melted it at the same time. It's not a particularly original line, but wherever there is light, there is also shadow. There is another world that cannot be brought about through idle talk, got it? I don't know what that's supposed to mean, but okay, I'll just let you have your one-liners. I may be an expert at studying Pokemon, but I'm no expert when it comes to battling them. But the guys in Lab A next door, they're pretty experienced with battles. After all, they spent so long researching that uncontrollable Pokemon. Ah, type Null they're talking about. Now we know. Hey, focus, people. We're Lily and Cosmog. We may have lost, but that doesn't mean we're going to help you. I'm not telling you anything. She's not here, is she? Even you can see that. These guys have brains. Usually they tell you everything after you beat them, but no, it's like, screw you. Come on, let's split up and look around. Maybe we'll find some clue. Time to look around and see if there's anything. That book looks suspicious. Aether Report, Ultra Wormholes. Beyond the Ultra Wormholes that Professor Moan discovered lies a different dimension. By investigating the changes in mass there, we can predict the existence of Pokemon-like life. We have dubbed them Ultra Beasts for now. So they were the ones that discovered the Ultra Beasts, huh? Interesting. And this computer over here. It's on Cosmog. Cosmog is hypothesized to be a type of Ultra Beast that hails from another dimension.
Wow.
Nebby, there's a lot you haven't been telling us, other than pew. That's literally all he could have told us. A dimension we have named Ultra Space. When placed under sufficient stress, it reveals the power to create and open ultra wormholes in order to escape from its suffering. We are now working on a device that will allow us to manipulate the ultra wormholes created when Cosmog is subjected to extreme stress. Wait, so Cosmog might be an ultra beast? We should tell Gladion about this. So, what they've essentially been doing is torturing Cosmog. They want to be able to torture it and open up ultra wormholes. That's incredibly inhumane, and that's like the most friendly word I could use at this point. We learned a bit about Cosmog. It might be an ultra beast or whatever, and if you stress it a lot, it can create ultra wormholes, maybe to run away or something? If you stress it. If you hurt it, is that what you mean? Was that why she ran away with it? We didn't find any sign of it down here. Yeah, Faba probably knew this would be a dead end. Darn, did he outsmart us? Well, even if he did outsmart us, it's a good thing we can just muscle our way out of any situation we encounter. All right, Hal's got the right idea. We got to finish this off together. All right, so Faba tricked us, and we're going to go ahead and persuade some more information out of him. But actually, first and foremost, Gladion's no longer guarding this door, so we should take a look and see what kind of information we can glean off of it. Suspicious-looking deleted files. Okay, 2, 5, 7, 11, 18, and 44. Let's go through each of them one at a time. BKP development record number 2. Anti-UB fighting lifeform Beast Killer. The president has approved the proposed budget for this development project, so it will be implemented. Okay, so Beast Killer, that's probably type null. Record 5. Materials for development have been collected from the Canalave Library in the Sinnoh region. Plans are being drawn up for the specifications of the type change program, known as the RKS system. Work is underway on designing the specifications of special memories for said system. Sinnoh region, RKS, type change. I think they're trying to create their own version of Arceus here. Or Arceus. If... Is this supposed to be Arceus? I mean, it's called the RKS system, so would it be Arceus then? I don't know. Collection of cells of all types for genetic modeling has been completed. Blueprints for the skeletal structure have been approved, and incubation of the bioframe is underway. So they went ahead and incorporated DNA in from Pokemon of every single type. That's probably what allows the RKS system to work. Record 11, dummy test of the RKS system program has been completed. Type has been successfully altered with all 18 special memories. The transplantation of the RKS system program to the models is underway. The BK's official name has been set as type full, as in full of every type. 18, production of the 3 models has been completed. They are identified as serial number 1, number 2, and number 3. All 3 models rejected the RKS system upon initialization during testing. Shortly after these initialization errors, all 3 models of type full went berserk. Okay, so they're having troubles with it. Record 44. Models have been fitted with control masks to mitigate the effects of their rejection of the RKS system. Due to the implementation of these control masks, our RKS system initialization tests have failed. All 3 models of type full are to be cryogenically frozen for the rest of eternity. The name of these models has been changed from type full to type null. Null meaning nothing. So, that's why Null wears the mask then. To control its temper, really. And we got a full restore. At least it's not a null restore. Anything on the computer? Something loaded on the screen. Okay. There's some more information here. The blog of F, a branch chief working in the Alola region. I wonder who it could be. Are you interested in success, dear readers? Then allow me to introduce myself. My name is F, and I'm an elite, self-made man. Here on my blog, I will show you the way to succeed. Currently, I am working on the development of a special sort of ball, which I took over from my predecessor in parallel with another project. Seeing how well I multitask impresses my subordinates and increases their motivation. Showing how skillful you are is a kind of on-the-job training for your underlings. I once ventured to undertake a project without notifying my superior. I developed a device to restrain a dangerous life form in case it became necessary to do so. I had it made for hedging risks to protect myself, but for better or worse, it was made public. It is always essential to consider the risks before one takes action. My superior's family stole the results of our research and ran off. However, I have chosen never to blow this issue out of proportion. I will only be reprimanded for my own mistakes, and surely my superior is also displeased with the actions of her family as well. When necessary, one must always be prepared to massage the truth to protect one's own position. It is not an exaggeration to say that this skill is vital for success. So that's obviously what Faba's written down. There are actually quite a few references there. The Pokeball they're developing, the control masks for Type Null, and the, the identity of his superior isn't exactly, it's common knowledge. I mean, it makes, you guys should use your common sense to figure out who he's working for. But the results of their research is most likely Cosmog and Type Null. So anyway, now that that's all done, we can finally continue on with the story, finding Faba and making him talk. Even beaten down, old Faba doesn't change, does he? What do we do? Beat whoever stands in our way. What other choice do we have? Fine, we can do that, but do you have to say "hmph" all the time? Oh, suddenly we're surrounded. Hello, children. I'm afraid a branch chief Faba has given us orders regarding you three. Now that you've learned of the darkness at the heart of Aether Paradise, we'll need you all to conveniently disappear. Alright. Yeah, how is it looking desperate? It's fight or be murdered. Literally. No exaggeration. And I forgot to switch Pokemon. I'll have to do that after this fight. Okay, who are we fighting? Mudsdale and Pelipper. Alright. I have no doubt that Raichu can take out that Pelipper. And Mudsdale has really good defenses. So we will use Flamethrower. And there we go, Electro Ball. Wrecked. Poor Pelipper. Gave him that pelvic thrust. It's a pretty funny animation. Oh, wait. Okay. High horsepower. That's a scary looking move. Come on, Raichu, finish him off. Okay, well, Raichu can finish him off, but Plague can. There we go. You guys are dazzling, horribly sparkling. The children of Alola who aim to be champion through the Island Challenge, they are not to be underestimated. Oh, you think? We've only left a trail of beaten grunts in our wake all throughout this raid. Ridiculous. Have the children of Alola always been this strong? That's what you get when you go through the island Trials of the Island challenge. Now that you understand, how about you get out of our way? Heh, no argument. When you're fighting a battle you can't afford to lose, you really can't waver at all, huh? Let's go. You know, I know we aren't friends, but I'm glad you two are here. I remember what you said at the Battle Royal Dome that day, about how people can achieve more if they do something together. Looks like maybe you were right. Young Master. Oh, it's Wiki. How is just... Do you see how what he was doing? Looking back and forth. So yeah, Wiki and Gladion know each other. That doesn't really surprise me, seeing as how Gladion already knows quite a bit of about Aether Foundation. It's clear he's been around here before.
What's happened to Lily? Do you know anything?
I imagine that she's with the president.
And that's where I'm going. That's all I need to know.
The president? That's Miss Luzamine, right? She's a really nice person, so I'm sure she'll listen to us if we explain everything.
Yeah, she's real nice. As long as you mean nothing to her.
But I'm afraid the doors have been locked. Again?
That's not stopping me.
Yep, alright. So, it's time to find what's-his-face, Faba, and interrogate him. I've got quite a few Pokemon that probably want to have a few words with him. Please look after Young Master Gladion. When he was worked up about something, he doesn't consider the consequences, even going so far as stealing Pokemon. Those two truly are very much alike. Just the... so much foreshadowing. So many bits of... so much a backstory being revealed. My, my. What naughty children. You should just lay your heavy heads down. But I knew that you would struggle onward. I could see through every action you would take. So I knew you would try to reach the president. And that is why I knew that I would be able to ambush you here and remedy my previous failure. The only reason I let you in the lower floor was to buy time to gather more staff to stop you. So, Mr. Faba, do you have the key to the president's rooms? Indeed, I have it right here. So if you just stayed hidden, we would have been stuck here anyway, right? What? Oh, snap. Enough, you lot. Teach these children a lesson.
We don't have time for this. Help me out here, Cottonmouth.
Alright, guess we're fighting with Gladion instead of against him this time. Employee and employee. What do you know? Magmar and Electabuzz. Oh dear. Two tough-looking opponents. But fortunately, I've got not one, but two Edgelords on my side. Let's start off with Honeclaws. Oh, I get the feeling that Golbat's really gonna feel that one. Acrobatics, though. Oh my god, why? Confuseray, just... freaking Confuseray. Alright, let's use Shadow Claw on Electabuzz. Come on, Edgelord. You can do it. Oh no. It broke its own disguise. Alright, fortunately, Gladion is more lava plume. That is a scary looking attack. And it burned Electabuzz. That's funny. That's really quite funny. Ah, bringing out the Chimera, are we? I bet you those employees recognize this Pokemon. Come on, Edgelord. You can do it. There we go. Light screen. Well, fortunately, Edgelord is a physical attacker, not a special attacker. And down he goes. Guess it's back to honest Pokemon conservation activities for me. Losing to you generated dark feelings in me. Yes. Feel the power of the dark side. Random Aether Foundation employee whose name I don't know.